Fear. Everything is already on fire across social media. Already, we have something to worry about with Zenless Zone Zero. The game I claimed would be the first domino in the puzzle solving the downfall of Genshin Impact's demise. From the previous beta test to this one, we're finding a massive nerf in gameplay. One so extraordinary it makes you wonder what in the hell the devs were even thinking. They nerfed the hell out of the giant gazongas, the plumpers, the hooters, the melons! Is there no humanity left? But, yeah, that's it. A good old-fashioned booba nerf has the community in an uproar. Don't get me wrong, I'm totally on board. I don't want to see any booba nerfs. We must protect them honkers. But also, it's not, like, the worst thing to ever happen. There's a lot to criticize or discuss from what we've seen so far in Zenless Zone Zero, but we'll get to that in just a moment. What's disappointing the most is that Hoyo clearly doesn't mind making games that are a bit more suggestive. They've even greenlit this game to be 16+ off the rip so they can just explore more mature themes. So where did these nerfs come from? Without making an incredibly direct statement one way or another, sometimes legislation is hard. Hoyoverse is based in China, and China has some strict rules about what they can show and what they cannot show to consumers. Many people are calling for two versions of the game to be developed, one for Eastern gamers and one for Western gamers, so we can keep those glorious knockers and disappoint our families. However, this did not work out well when they attempted the very same feat in Honkai Impact 3rd. After attempting such, they still received penalties for their attempts, likely dissuading them from ever trying again. At the end of the day, they're a corporation. They're in it to make money and dominate the market. If there are costly legal roadblocks ahead, like going toe-to-toe with the CCP, it's no wonder why they have course-corrected and are steering clear of potential violations of law. For those familiar with Genshin, this is Rosaria Gate all over again. They did that woman dirty, as she alone received two nerfs over time. This change was made to get official approval faster from that very government, which is a very good thing for like players who want to get their hands on the game, namely me. I didn't get a beta key, I really want the game. Please, Hoyo clearly has a timeline that they want to meet, and they're willing to sacrifice insano-style airbags for. What does this mean? The change cannot and will not ever be reverted. This is the way things will be. With this said, and all jokes aside, I think the community reaction is just, it's been a bit too bombastic. However, I can understand where they're coming from because it wasn't enough. They shaved down booba metrics. They've also gone about nerfing the animations that accentuate certain features. And now I'm back on board. Outrage is understandable. To a degree, the players want some big booba women present in their stylish combat game. Though, I must say, I'll gladly compromise some booba for a company that is uninhibited in making content for their game. Truth be told, that's all I really care about. Is the game fun? The combat system in Zenless Zone Zero looks very fun at first glance. The animations are clean, and you just look and feel cool while you're executing your combos or perfectly timed swap parries. This is exactly what I was hoping for, refining the combat system Genshin used of swapping characters into different types of combos. It's just fun. Also, yes, I am aware that it's apparently more like Honkai Impact 3rd. I've just never played Honkai Impact 3rd, so it's hard for me to personally say. They do have striking similarities, though, but I'll have to rely on the community's word for this, and honestly, it does seem pretty solid, so I'll leave that there. However, I cannot tell if this is just fatigue from watching so many clips or VODs of streams, but it almost seems a bit repetitive. I'm aware we don't have a whole lot of enemies or characters to play yet, but even within the small pool we have, things seem to get repetitive quickly. It's a little worrisome from someone who can't play yet, but there might be good news. I felt similar with Genshin's playstyle. It visually looks repetitive when you're consuming a lot of content, but when you're in there, you're having a blast. I'm very hopeful about this. There have been some criticisms of the game. While more difficult and refined than Genshin, still lacks proper depth and difficulty. This would be more concerning to me if it weren't just in beta, still. I think Hoyo should, however, give us a proper showcase of the depth they intend to take combat difficulty. For those familiar with WoW or Final Fantasy XIV rating, I'd love to see some fights that take a proper dance to avoid mechanics while dishing out massive amounts of damage. I don't mean a super complex fight that takes players days to figure out, just to be clear. I just want to avoid the tank and spank, static enemies that offer little to no resistance, and then fall over after about 2 minutes of damage. Some huge raid bosses, maybe even something we can tackle with our friends, would be absolutely incredible and can turn the gaming world on its head. I'm very hopeful for the potential that this game presents so far. The real goal Zenless Zone Zero could offer, in my opinion, is taking these static story characters and allowing them to be thrown into multiple different genres of games, from a beat-em-up to exploration, back to roguelite or roguelike. While not wildly different, being able to express your characters in a multitude of systems feels amazing, and I'm kind of hoping this is what they tackle with their arcade system. Proof of this can be found in Honkai Star Rail. The Swarm Simulated Universe mode feels incredibly transformative, and it's so much fun. In a game that's as simple as a turn-based combat system, to feel so wildly transformative and fresh is an absolute breath of that very fresh air. I hope Hoyo has learned this lesson from HSR and all the positive feedback it has received. From the looks of it already, they sort of have. As an in-game feature that has been presented in this closed beta test, we see Hollow Zero, a roguelike game mode. This is super positive, and I'm excited to see future iterations on its current design, because as it stands now, it seems a little bit bland for what it could be. Something that is giving me a bit of pause, however, is the energy system. They seem to be attempting a rehash of Honkai Impact 3rd. Their intentions seem to be artificially slowing down player progression with time. This is very worrisome for the launch of a game when all the hype is there, but it does go away once we enter a form of maintenance mode and we're just waiting for content patches. So how exactly is the energy system working now? We have a cap of 180 energy that takes a full 24 hours to recharge, something I am very thankful for and still wondering why Genshin cannot have it. Please, why, dude? Why? Anyway, main story quests cost 5 energy and side quests cost 20 to start slash complete. At first glance, to those who may not be aware, this doesn't seem too bad. 5 energy to complete a main story quest, right? And only but acceptable, right? As many seasoned players are aware, however, this is really bad because of the 20 cost of the side quest. In these games, it's important to level your account quickly so that you can get access to higher rewards, also more rewards, for completing energy cost objectives. The more rewards you get, the faster you can level all of your characters. But it doesn't stop there. You can level your characters higher as well, so a sort of snowball effect can occur. The faster you get ahead, the faster you can do everything. Hoyo leaves big gaps between main story quests, both to slow down your progression and to incentivize you to complete side story quests for those juicy bits of experience. Each side story quest will give you a comparably smaller amount of experience than the main story quest, so it would seem we would be dumping a lot of energy into hoovering up all that side story experience. And at the end of the day, it's a simple solution. Just play less for it, but that kind of sucks. It just sucks. I just want to play the game. Why am I being hindered? Why am I being time-gated? This is a very company-forward decision such that the players will take a massive L, in my humble opinion. I hope they consider changing this, at the very least, but at the end of the day, it's not exactly a deal-breaker. It's just another piece of straw on the camel's back. I just don't want to see the day they pile on more, and eventually crush that camel. Unfortunately, some additional forms of straw might already be found, amusingly, in the UI. For this final section, we're going to do a catch-all of complaints heard from players, just to put them out there. If you have an opinion on them, please let me know. I'd love to hear what players consuming ZZZ content are thinking. And you can do so, just leave a comment down there. You know, I'll be reading them all the time. But back to the UI. While the TV mechanic is interesting at first, it can easily be seen as gimmicky, as it takes you out of the game to complete a relatively mundane task that isn't even that fast either. Players are complaining about how slow and awful it feels to navigate menus. Personally, this is a huge turnoff for me. I love when things feel snappy. Oh my goodness, woo! Animations, of course, are beautiful, but let me opt out of it, please. I have some ADHD thing going on, I'm not really sure, and slow menus make me want to tear my skin off, okay? Tear my skin off. Do you know how crazy that is? That's what happens. I don't want that, please. I would like to keep my skin. This isn't really a complaint, but I've seen some people mention it, that the story has a very goofy vibe, and I'm personally really into that, so we'll see what happens. I hope we can see some serious storytelling down the line, though, as a good balance between it would probably be for the best. But after the story in Genshin's 4.0 to 4.2 patch, minus Paimon, of course, and the HSR 1.5 patch, I have a lot of faith in Hoyo's storytelling capabilities. It seems Hoyo is very aware of the data they want and need, as they are asking very intentional questions about players' experiences. As a large part and reason for this beta, they're sending out questionnaires targeting exact concerns people are having over synergies and combat. Hopefully with good feedback, the future of ZZZ will be very bright, but I remain a bit more hesitant than I was before. I think going into the game without dewy eyes would be really nice for me. Maybe I'll slowly fall in love and play for a really long time, rather than obsess early on and then burn out once my expectations are not met. Of course, nothing is actually promised, so developing these expectations is very scary. At the moment, these topics seem to be the main discussion points. I wanted to discuss them and give feedback for Zenless on Zero as an outsider who's been racking up watch time of streams like no other. I want a key so bad, people. I have attempted to be as fair as I can in my discussion or criticisms, but let me know if I missed anything. Also, last quick note, the male MC looks incredibly gross. He looks like a Megamind in the making. What is Koyo can literally design characters that look like Zhongli, and then they go about making child with the biggest head in the world. I don't know what's happening over there. Give us a better male MC, please, because I'm gonna have to choose him, and I don't want to. And I'm bummed out, Hoyo. I'm not gonna lie. I'm a little bummed out. But that's not the only thing bumming me out. I'm kind of bummed out about not being able to get into the beta as well, but making this video has honestly been kind of a big relief. And it's therapeutic in a way, and I've just had a good time making it. So thanks for watching. And I appreciate all the support. So if you've enjoyed this video, I hope you did. Maybe you'll leave a like and maybe subscribe if you haven't. But that's all for me for now. So see ya.